Hey you gentle cuties, Mark Goon here. Today I'm going to talk about why you should never sign with a record label. Labels are archaic, piece of shit, tasteless vulture suits whose entire business models revolve around mercilessly exploiting those they're purported to help by wielding an unbalanced power dynamic to plunder the ownership rights of creators, all while dangling a tri-tip carrot of validation, fortune, and fame to squeeze every last drop of profitability out of artists while laughing their shittily dressed asses to the bank. But stick around and I'll let you know how I really feel. Back in the day, labels employed talent scouts called A&Rs whose job it was to unearth undiscovered artists and nurture and develop them into respectable money printing machines. Labels used to have to rely on taste in order to determine who to sign, which was a bummer for labels because while having good taste is literally the only requisite for being a quality artist, it's not exactly a quality that's found in exceedingly high supply in corporate headquarters. In the year of our Lord 2021, I still hear some of my artist friends giving reasons why they think they need a record label. They'll say things like,
"But Mark, I need money to make music."
Well, a label isn't giving you money. They're just giving you a loan, and the funny thing about loans are, you gotta pay them back. If a label's willing to give you a $100,000 advance, it's because they've projected you're going to be worth a hell of a lot more than that $100,000 very soon. Of course, in some cases, you may not. Labels still have to put up the capital and they're still taking a bit of a gamble. I'll give them that. But labels are gambling in the same sense a casino is gambling by letting a blue-haired octogenarian pour her retirement savings into a slot machine. The only difference is, should she hit the jackpot, the label reserves the right to keep 80% of it. Here's the good news. You don't need money anymore to make quality music. Record in your bedroom. Shoot a video on your phone. Edit on your laptop. Do a photo shoot in your front yard. Download GIMP and make your album artwork for free. And once you start generating revenue, if you really need some more money, take out a small business loan. This is essentially the same thing as the advance you get from the label, except the bank doesn't seize ownership rights to your recordings for the next 46 years. In addition, I know NFTs are a big buzzword right now, but I think they're gonna change everything very, very soon. Upcoming artists could allow fans to have equity on the ground floor of someone they believe in without selling ownership stake of their entire future catalogs. Say you sell a couple NFTs of your first album or EP that includes a 10% equity stake in that project forever. This allows your early fans to make an investment in an artist they believe in and gives you the budget to shoot bigger videos or hire more accomplished producers or have a bit of a marketing budget or whatever. I've also heard some of my artist friends saying,
"Yeah, Mark, I know labels aren't ideal, but I'm an artist, not a CEO. I need a team to help me."
Okay. Hire your creative friends. Give your videographer friend a piece of the song they shoot the video for. Give your producer a much larger chunk of ownership of the song than the label would ever give them. If you can't pay cash right now, offer them upside. Find people who are hungry and on the same level as you. This is so, so, so important. There are talented 18, 19, 23-year-old kids all over the world who have a passion for directing and would love the opportunity to start building their portfolio. Go find creative people on the internet and build from the ground up together. Finally, I'm sure some people will say,
Okay, we get it. Labels don't really offer you money and you can build a team yourself. But surely a label offers you connections that are helpful.
What connections? Radio? Who cares? Playlisting? Okay. If you're on a label roster with 50 other artists, how hard is that label really pushing to get you placed on editorial playlists? Are all 50 other artists on your label getting placed? Or maybe just 3 or 4 or 5? There's a finite amount of spots on Rap Caviar. Is your label really gonna push for you to get that last slot and tell Travis Scott to go fuck himself? I've also heard him say,
"What about getting big name features?"
So the label gets you a feature with Lil Laramie for 75K and your song does 5 million streams. Congrats. Now you're an additional 50K in debt to the label. In conclusion, labels exploit artists' innate need for validation. They throw a budget behind you. They make sure you're seen and heard. And your art finally gets attention. But now you no longer own your art. In fact, now you're in debt in perpetuity to the label for the budget they put behind you to make your art profitable for them. And then they just simply move on to the next young, upcoming artist to squeeze every last cent out of, and you're left with absolutely fucking nothing. Next week, I'm going to talk about why you should sign to my new label, Squish My Tomato Records. Thank you guys for watching, and have a gentle day.